One day.
I love even. It's very tedious and time consuming, but I still love it. I am an artist. Also, I do tie-dyeing, hand painting, and weaving. I love weaving more because weaving is very different. And what if I can create more fabrics to do anything I want to do it. From child, I was always artistic because I'm dyslexic. That means I have problems reading and spelling. So I always have problems reading and spelling, even from very small. And I didn't know exactly what the problem was. And sometimes I get very frustrated and I can't spell simple words like the. And even my father, he'd get frustrated with that and he couldn't understand why he couldn't spell the words, that kind of thing. So I just try to make a lot of stuff. I press them out, police do metal work and woodwork. So I always love you using my hands. But I developed my weaving from here just about 35 years ago, 1987. I had just came back from Trinidad and wasn't working, so I had to find something to do. And then I was doing tie-dye at the time, I did a lot of tie-dye. But then I went to the career showcase at Sylvester Michael School. And there was a young lady there on the loom doing some weaving. I thought, wow, this is interesting. I want to do that. And she let me use the loom. I tell her, wait, how can I learn to do that? She said, me go to the IDC. I tell her, IDC was doing weaving on there. So I went to IDC and I learned to weave. It took me about 3 to 6 months to learn to weave. And I got a loom and then I started weaving. And over the years, I tried to develop my own style of weaving. I love the way to play, and once the play moves that I like, that would really help me to move in. That helps me to move in the zone to it. Feel the fabric, and I would just go into the zone. I just go, just go. As I weave, depending on what I'm using, different things have my head, and then I create different stuff. So that weaving, it definitely calms me, and definitely really sets me in a different zone. And when I get in that zone, I just love to be in that zone. I would stay in that zone maybe for a whole day. Once I have the time, I would just weave. I just weave, maybe till 9, 10 o'clock at night. And I don't like the phone, not the humbug when I start weaving. I think I really need to get some heavy marketing. Yeah, and some way to content, that kind of thing. So from what I have done so far, I think a lot of people love my work, and I think that I can do much better if I have somebody do marketing. I do a lot better. When I'm not making art, I love to cook, and I love to bake especially. So I bake breads, I bake cake, fruit cakes. I love soup. I can eat soup every day, all day. Love soup. If I travel in a place for the first time, I walk the whole area, walk the whole village, whole place. I just like to walk. I walk hours, just to discover, see stuff, look at things, and I just want to walk, be explaining myself. So I take pictures of flowers, take pictures of a dog or house, of anything that I think is interesting that I want to capture that, to keep it, to do it for something at some other point. This tutor I'm done here, I bless all myself. I had somebody help me with the columns, but all the carpentry I did it myself. I really want to pass on this craft. I want to carry that loom and train that for my daughter and teach her to weave. And we as artists, we need to tell a story what's happening in our time, so that person, my children and grandchildren come on, they'll see what was happening with me and my life at my particular time. My wall hangings definitely tell that kind of story. That's who I am. Sylvester Adelabu.